Welcome back to the kitchen. You are here with Team Mad Rational in the building. You are here with your man Twitch for Life and Mr. Art on number two on the Couchcast. So we just kicking it today. Just doing what we do.
Just kicking it. Talking.
So what I don't want any more of is I'm tired of the nonsense from like the White House. Like completely. Like I'm tired of the fact that it's like a circus act. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's like,
what else does anybody expect from putting a, you know, a reality star, a reality TV star in office?
No, this is exactly what I expected.
That's exactly it. It's like this is a circus. That's all it is. That being said, he's got the potential going for something. He's not him, you know, himself, but like what he's doing,
like
it's creating, it's kind of that idea of like creating a rubber band effect.
It's like following the policies of everybody that was both before him almost.
Well, he's breaking it down. He's at least in a way that like people are really starting to reexamine how we do things, how we,
Well, of course people start to pay attention because it's entertaining. It is reality TV. Right. You've got a porn star scandal.
Well, yeah. I mean,
you know what I mean?
There's all that, but I'm saying like, but people are starting to realize that like, what the government is and like the things that they've got their fingers in and like what they have had their fingers in and then haven't been doing well. We've given so much power to this idea of the federal government, and they're not good at the things that we have them doing.
But I think that comes from people not paying attention in the past. Like,
right.
We have full control over how much power they have, regardless of what people think. You know what I mean? You get out there, you vote, but you gotta vote at the right elections too.
You gotta vote at all the elections because they all matter.
But what happens is the same the current generation mm-hmm. went out and put some time in to vote on this election. Mm-hmm. But then right after that election, when you're voting for your state representatives, mm-hmm. that's where the people that's been voting for state representatives were, it seemed like, the only ones that went out and voted.
Still, yeah.
Right. And it's like, hold on, these are just as important as the other one.
They're more important. I think that's something I've been trying to like, well, see, that's the thing. Like, it's kind of that idea of like, what do we let the federal government take care of? We have them looking at things that, you know, the federal government shouldn't have to worry about, things that the states should be worrying about, something that a local government should be worrying about, like anybody's rights, like social justice rights in general should be a state issue. When the government's trying to do that and handle, it can't even handle its own finances, let alone handle everybody else's finances. So when you let the state governments handle these things, it's a far more localized biosphere as far as all that goes. And your vote has a little more sway within that within that realm. And then on the other hand, like something I've just heard recently, and it makes so much sense. If you don't like the way something's happening in one state, if that was the ideal way we had things set, if you don't like the way something works in one state, move to another state.
Move.
When you have all that power going to the government, when they say you can't smoke weed, you can't have, you know, alternative weddings, get gay marriage,
right?
You can't do X, Y, and Z. Like, what is your alternative? It's to move to another country,
right? So if you want to be around people who are like you and think like you, mm-hmm. then that's perfectly fine, and you should have that freedom,
absolutely,
inside of the United States. Then if the states control Right. So here's the, I think the point everybody misses. People keep worrying about what's right and what's wrong based on their beliefs and values. And the state laws should be based around a community of people who value and believe, or a majority of people in that community mm-hmm. who value and believe the same things, right?
Right?
And so the laws reflect that, or the statutes and all those things reflect that community.
Right.
Right? And then you have another community in a whole nother state that, you know, has a different basis. And so people who are like-minded to that reside there.
Right.
Right? We got to stop trying to make these one-off issues countrywide problems.
Right.
You know? And for instance, weed.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So weed becomes a big issue for a lot of people because they're like, it's a drug. But that's not the issue at hand,
no.
Whether or not it's a drug, because if you look at the facts, the actual facts, cigarettes and alcohol are much more detrimental to a person's health than weed is.
Cigarettes, alcohol, sugar, yeah. Caffeine.
Yeah.
Any kind of substance that creates any kind of, you know, vast amounts of vitamin C. Like, there's a lot of drugs that we consume on a daily basis. It's right. Not a big deal that nobody thinks about.
Right. If you take too much ibuprofen, your whole liver is going to shut down.
Right.
I mean, all your kidneys. I'm sorry. All your kidneys is going to shut down. Right. You have stage 4 kidney disease real quick. Right.
Well, that's
but you can buy these things over the counter.
Yeah.
Because well,
like, what are the drugs that kids are getting into now? Like, you can smoke some weed, or you can get into Xanax, and
right, or you can chew on a Tide Pod.
Right.
It's like,
yeah,
you know what I mean. You can chew on a Tide Pod. You can snort a condom.
Right.
You know what I mean. It's like,
I think I'm a big proponent for legalize it all and let people make their own decisions,
yeah.
Good, bad, or indifferent. Like. We're
decades behind the rest of the world in this.
Yeah. I mean, especially once it's legalized, once, you know, then you can get organizations to get in and regulate so that people aren't dying because of fentanyl overdoses.
Yeah.
Or, you know, just bad actors coming in and doing bad things, and you can start getting, I think that's a big thing that we haven't been looking at because it's been illegal to look at, is data collection for was it marijuana or alcohol or cigarettes, something like that. It was one of those drugs that, like, one of those things that, you know, people do, but it's because of the way they had the law set up, it was that we couldn't record any information from any of these things that were going on.
Mm-hmm.
So we had no idea what was actually happening with these drugs, who was taking them, and who, you know, how many people were dying. I mean, obviously weed isn't killing anybody, and
right,
I mean, the other two are, but, you know, it is what it is. I'm pro weed. I don't smoke it, but I'm pro it.
Like, you can smoke as much weed as you want.
Yeah.
And the only thing that's going to happen is you're going to fall asleep and wake up hungry.
Right. But, I mean, you probably shouldn't drive on it.
Absolutely.
You probably shouldn't operate heavy machinery. I mean, it should be on par with alcohol, I think.
Yeah, but it takes a lot of... I mean, maybe not. Maybe it'd be the same amount of time, you know, on the substance. However, alcohol kills people every single day, and it's legal.
Yeah.
Every single day somebody dies from an alcohol-related issue or accident. You know what I'm saying? But, like, we take this other thing over here that has, like, no record of overdoses. You know?
Yeah.
And it's illegal.
Yeah.
And it's actually good. It's not only, like, not really bad for you, but it's, like, good for the environment and good for crops.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I mean, raw tobacco is good for crops, too.
Yeah.
You know, if you plant that, but it's, you know, because okay, so you know more about the farming than I do, but yeah. You plant the tobacco in the off season in order to make the ground more fertile for the
Something like that. I don't know. There's something about, you know,
like rotating,
rotating the crops so that you're getting like the nitrogen and the other, you know, things that the crops need to grow.
Yeah. So I heard that's what that it was something like that. I don't know exactly, but something like that they did, you know, when you were, you know, growing your crops on like, you know, large farmlands and stuff like that. But now they have a lot more technology and chemicals that go into stuff like that.
Not necessarily the best thing.
No. Yeah. No.
We can go into that on a later date. That's a whole lot of mess.
I mean, so I looked into a little bit the idea of hydroponics.
Okay.
Right. And the only reason I looked into it is because I'm a huge Star Trek fan. Right. And every Star Trek ship has a hydroponics bay.
Right.
And I was like, okay, I know on the hydroponics bay they grow plants and vegetables and fruit, but I didn't really know like what was different about it. And I was like, okay, so do a little bit of research. And I was like, oh shit, this makes a lot more sense. Why don't we do it?
Right. I mean, I think we've had this conversation a few times where I've brought this up in conversation rather, but I'm a big proponent for vertical farming, which are the you know, transportable trailers basically with rows of vertically hanging crop troughs. It's all hydroponics, but it's the way that it works is that the water that is given to the top row then releases the water to the next row and to the next row and to the next row, so you're not wasting water because some ridiculous amount of water is being wasted whenever we water crops. But then you can, since it's all done inside of a enclosed ecosystem, then you don't have to worry about the like insects getting at it, so you don't have to worry about pesticides, you don't worry about weeds growing around it, so you don't have to worry about I don't know what it's called, Roundup or any of those types of...
Like fertilizers?
Well, any of those types of...
Soil enhancers? Like,
the things that keep, you know, the undesirables out of the ground. And then since you're working with far condensed amount of dirt and area that the plants grow in,
yeah,
you don't have to worry about replacing the nutrients in the soil to the same... place. Plus that stuff isn't going into the water system, which is kind of the issues that it gets into the water system and then it all comes out of the butthole of the United States, the Mississippi into the Gulf, and then
from the Gulf to the Pacific.
It basically fertilizes things like algae, and algae grows
into the Pacific to the Atlantic Ocean.
It grows really quick. Algae grows quick, and I forgot what it's called. So something like algae blooms or floral blooms, or there's some kind of thing for it. But the algae grows in big clouds that need oxygen to survive. So it draws the oxygen from the water, which in turn kills the fish because there's no oxygen in the water. Yeah.
Because even though fish are in water, ladies and gentlemen, they still need oxygen. Still need oxygen. So I don't know if you guys know this, but water is two parts hydrogen, one part oxygen. I don't know if anybody knew that. Just wanted to make that clear.
So I mean, there's a lot of like I'm not a vegan. I'm not like one of those that are like, oh, you can't farm, you can't raise animals, you can't.
No.
I mean, ideally we would.
But you're a realist.
Ideally, we would get past that. We would find better ways to do things that,
you know,
that's cleaner, that is a lot, you know, more morally all right.
But, I mean, even look at the civil engineering aspect of it.
Right.
So if you're using less land, that's more land for... other things, you know, economic development.
Right.
Right. So you don't have to have, you know, 40,000 miles of farmland, right? You can get away with like 20,000.
You don't have to drop hundreds of thousands of dollars on equipment, farming equipment,
right? Which, so just to share with the world, so there was a game. Okay, so I was curious, right? So every now and then, like, curiosity hits, and I'm looking at this game, and I had the complete wrong idea about it because I was thinking it was like the 15th one in the series. Oh, it never dawned on me that that was the year, but whatever, because it was farming, it wasn't sports. But so, like, Farming Simulator, was it 15?
Yeah.
So I'm looking at it, I'm like, dang, you know, every review was like 5-star review on it. Every single review people wrote was a, like, this outstanding and excellent review. I'm like, it's a farming game. Like, guys, like, I just wanted everybody to know, it's a farming game, man. And so I found it on my Xbox Game Pass, and I was like, hey, let me just download it right quick. So I downloaded it, and the craziest thing happened. Now, I'm going to let you guys know, I'm a black dude from New Orleans. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no farming in the city, all right? We don't farm nothing. There's the occasional flower pot. You might grow a bell pepper here and there. You know what I mean? Maybe some green onion, a tomato.
A little cilantro
right, on the side. You know what I'm saying? Some parsley. You know what I'm saying? But that's about as far as it goes in the city. I found myself on this game like 6 hours in. And like Art shows up. It's like, bro, what are you doing? I'm like, bro, I found this game. It's dope. He's like, what is it? It's Farming Simulator 15. Right. And so I start talking about all this equipment and stuff that I've discovered and all the crops and everything. And so he jumps on it. And then for like a solid week, all we did was play this farming game.
Yeah.
Until we figured out how to work the system, and then it didn't matter anymore.
Right.
You know, build it. If you guys don't know, if you guys are playing the game and you don't know how to like just win, go buy the wind turbine. Just go do that. Buy the wind turbine, buy like 6 of them and you win. Cool. That's it.
Wasn't it? You buy the wind turbines so you can afford the solar power things.
No, you buy the solar power things first and then you afford the wind turbine.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, that just happened.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, anyway, back to the hydroponics, right? Because that was really, it was a really fun week for me. Like, I was discovering new things. I was learning some stuff. I was learning some things about, like, tractors and equipment. And, like, I didn't know this much technology went into farming.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, my idea was farming was a dude in overalls and, a hoe. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That was my idea of farming. He might have had some chickens and some cows, and he'd go out and milk the cows and collect the eggs. That was what I thought farming was until I realized that, man, it's like 62 different types of tractors, and, you know, you got all kinds of things like harvesters, and the harvesters have to have specific types of shafts on them and trailers, and, man, you could turn grass into biofuel and stuff. I was like, what? Nonsense.
It's a dope game.
Yeah.
It's dope.
So it's a simulator, so it's like it's real, you know. It simulates realness, man.
I think that's what a simulator is.
I know, but for the world out there from the city of New Orleans that you know may have only played like Flight Simulator and not like diving, try it out. You'll learn something. Like you'll learn something for real. I was mildly surprised. I was much more than mildly surprised. Every now and then I go and check on my farm. Like, you still making money though?
Do you still? Yeah, I kind of knew about a lot of it just coming from Nebraska, where that's you drive an hour in any direction, you're in a farm, you're in a field. Mm. But like, I didn't know the specifics. I don't know how deep it got.
See, if you drive an hour in any direction here, one direction you might get shot, the other direction you might get hung, another direction you could get a really good burger, and then the other direction you would get some crawfish. So,
what about this Kendrick Lamar thing?
Wait, you talking about with the little girl?
With the young lady.
So look, okay, let's go through all the things that Kendrick did here.
Young man, Mr. Kendrick did.
So look, Kendrick, I love you. You're my homie. You make music that I enjoy, even though I wasn't a huge fan of the last two albums. Whatever. What? I wasn't.
That's real. That's real.
I wasn't. I'm sorry. You know what I'm saying? You make dope music. I just wasn't a fan of the last two albums. However, you have a plethora of tracks to choose from that don't involve the N-word every three words. That you could let everybody sing. And they probably know. But you chose this one. You chose this one, Mr. Kendrick. And then you chose to make an example out of the white girl that probably sings your song in her car with every word there because it's on your CD that you allowed her to buy, right? That's there. She probably sings it like that all the time. Now, I'm positive that this girl was just in the moment, feeling the energy on the stage.
And probably the alcohol.
And probably the alcohol. And she probably had some contact high from weed in the air. Mm-hmm. I'm positive of it, right? And so then we gonna call this girl out like she did something like evil. You know what I mean? Now, granted, there's groups of people that you can go around and there's things that you can't say. Mm-hmm. Wherever you go. It doesn't matter what race you are. There's things you cannot say, mm-hmm. right? However, you can't put something out to the public that they're supposed to like and enjoy. And of course, especially if it's music, people are going to sing along, right? When they listen to it in their car and feel the same energy, want to feel the same energy that you putting out on the track, and then use that as a platform to make an example out of the young girl for just feeling the energy that you put out.
Right.
That's not right.
I think we kind of skip over the idea that context matters, right?
Yeah.
Like, if they're enjoying your song, they're enjoying your culture, you can use that word all you want because you are part of the family. Like, you are here for us. Oh, what did Charlamagne say about that?
So of course, like, Charlamagne gave you the girl donkey today, right? Rightfully so. Because in that setting, you know, she should have the presence of mind to second guess everything that's about to happen. However, there was also a call out to Kendrick. You know, same thing that I just said. Like, you put it out there. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? For the girl to sing on stage, you can't be mad for her just singing the words that you put out there.
No, you know the words to your own song. You know
what they are. Do better. Like, seriously.
You let her believe every other word. That doesn't make any sense.
No, right.
Who's going to do that?
Right. The rules should have been stated ahead of time.
Right.
Like, if you're just going to have the rules, your rules should have been stated ahead of time.
I see. It may be just because I'm not outrightly part of the community that is represented by this word, but I'm on board with, I think, Travis Scott. He had a similar situation where he had a young white person come up on stage and sing his song, and this person said the N-word during one of his tracks, and the crowd started going, and he stopped the song. He said, you know what, this is a good thing. This means that we've gotten to the point where this word does not need the power that it's being given. Like, to the point where this word has been trivialized and is just part of a rap lyric. This is just a term of endearment. This is a term that we use all the time. There is no malice in this word as it's used by this young man or woman. I think that's the right way to handle that.
Well, the fact of the matter is, like, words don't have any inherent negative or positive connotation.
Right.
They only have those connotations depending on context.
Right.
It's context clues that tell you everything.
Right.
Right. It's not like we're in, you know, we're speaking other languages where context clues aren't always a part of the language, right? Where you have vocal inflections that tell you exactly what's happening.
Right.
Right. Context clues are everything.
Right.
You know what I mean? If I was like, yo, Man, that track was bad, bro.
Yeah. I mean, within context, it right. makes sense. If you're taking it literally.
Right. Like, man.
It doesn't make sense.
That track was bad.
Yeah.
It was real bad.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But
the English language.
Let me start it on this debauchery we call the language.
It's a positive thing overall, I think.
Let me state this, though. Just because we feel this sentiment about it does not mean that you can go to your local hood and just start saying the N-word. That's not what this means. No. Because just because you have freedom of speech also means you have freedom of consequences. I just want to let you know.
Right.
So,
well, there is a reason why that word is not illegal. It's not illegal to use that word.
Right.
There is the opposite rule that people are still going to look at you dirty if you just pop off using that word.
Right.
It doesn't mean you're a bad person. It just means you gotta know when and where, time and place.
Yeah, for sure.
You gotta know who you're with. Know, you know.
Right. I don't want to hear nothing. None of y'all, nobody that listens or watches the podcast talking about. But Twitch said. Twitch did not say. That's not what Twitch said. That's not what we're talking just about.
Use your mind. Like, don't.
It's not what we're saying. You did not get a get out of jail free card here. That's
right.
Not what you got. I did not hand that to you.
Why can't we just be nice to each other? What happened to that? Where is that?
That's back in Candyland where we left.
Right. Right.
I still like this track. I just don't like the way it starts.
You don't like it?
I don't like the way it starts.
Why not?
Because it... I don't like fading in.
Oh yeah, I'm with
I
you
want
on
an,
that.
I want an intro. Give me an intro.
Yeah.
Don't just fade in a droning beat that stays. You know what I mean?
Bobby Ray.
Dang, you just threw me under the bus. Shit.
No.
I like this track. Like, I like the intro.
I've been listening to more of her music, and it's really good.
She's awesome.
Got a voice. Yeah.
I told you. Yeah. She got that Toni Braxton sound.
Mm-hmm.
She really sounds really good, man. Shoot. You know what? Who's we watching earlier? You know who else music I like? But like, you'd be afraid to tell people you like it because then they get the wrong idea. But like, I'm Tekashi 6ix9ine tracks, man. It's kinda hot. He's got the one song, Billy. The beat is so hot.
I think, his production's on point. But I don't.
You cannot be a fan of him. It's like, the music is dope. I like the videos.
I don't like the videos. But, I don't like him. I don't like the videos. I don't like his words.
So look.
I don't like who what he's about.
You know, he's reminiscent of.
What's that?
He's reminiscent of a mixture of two classic artists.
Okay.
Ready? DMX and Lil Jon.
Okay. Musically, yes. I see.
Yeah.
That. Musically, yes.
And that's why I like it, because I'm like, he's got the attitude of and the like the scream of Lil Jon, and then kind of like that grunge of DMX.
The dirt from DMX.
Yeah, man. You know, he doesn't have the lyrical skills of anyone.
No.
But you know, like, the sound is very. Very DMX Lil Jon.
Does Lil Jon have lyrical skills?
I mean, he's got at least three words we know of.
So you're saying he's got the lyrical skills beyond that of Lil Jon, but where is he on par of, like, DMX?
He's nowhere. He's not touching DMX.
Not touching DMX.
Not lyrically. Fair. Not lyrically. Sound-wise. Like the sound,
yeah,
of
this is
voice.
Very similar. I get the connection.
But even like the way he puts together his words aren't as trash as other people, like Lil Yachty or Lil Uzi Vert. You know what I'm saying? Like, he doesn't have a trash phraseology happening in the song.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. It's but he's got a lot of hype tracks. You know.
Yeah. I mean, they're all. They're all just screaming. I don't like it. Screaming and violent, and I get they're hype tracks. They're club party music, and I'll give them The one thing I'll give him is that his music, I'd rather hear his music in a club, I'd rather hear his music out live over anything Migos, over anything Lil Yachty,
oh,
Lil
for sure.
Pump,
for,
Lil.
Yes.
What's his name? The with the red hair.
Oh, that's Lil Pump.
Oh, who's the other one? Gucci Gang.
That's Lil Pump.
That's Lil Pump.
That's
who's,
Lil Pump.
Who's the other one?
So,
I mean, they're all the same. They're all the same. I get them all.
Well, I don't want no Kodak Black. Right. I don't want no Lil Pump. No Lil Uzi Vert. No Lil Yachty. None of the Lils. Give it all the Lils. If you ain't got Lil in, I don't want to talk to you. I want to hear you. None of that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Bow Wow. His new stuff. Get that out of here.
Get that. Yeah. Make it funny. Oh, dude. Bow Wow. Sorry. You really not nothing without Jermaine Dupri.
Ooh.
Sorry.
It's true, but ooh.
Sorry. Truth hurts.
Truth hurts, Hermie.
I'm sorry, man. Like, you was dope when Jermaine Dupri was running the game, but, like, that's because Jermaine Dupri is a legend. Jermaine Dupri single-handedly created the early 2000s and late 90s hip-hop. Like, he headed that by himself. I'm just saying.
I didn't really like him on a track, though.
But you liked him as a producer?
Yes. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Who else is like that? The producers that they're knocking it out of the park as far as like in the studio, but then they get behind the mic and it's like,
oh, Puffy.
Yeah.
Birdman.
I can listen to a Birdman track though. I'm not like.
You can listen to a Birdman and Manny Fresh track.
Accurate. Yeah.
Come Manny Fresh is dope.
Yeah.
Birdman yeah. behind the board, amazing. When he's directing a project, comes out amazing. Put Birdman on the mic,
hit miss.
It's a lot of misses.
Mostly misses.
A lot of misses. You know what I mean? Oh man, look at that girl right there. Goodness gracious, girl fine. She knows she's fine.
What is that?
That's Chris Tucker and Michael Jackson. Rock your world. Rock my world. That's
yeah.
It.
Chris. You see a Chris? She is banging.
So when are we going to put these online? When are we going to start doing that?
I mean... Where should we put them? iTunes?
Well, yeah. Yeah.
We have them all bounced. They're all in my Dropbox.
So for those of you listening, our shows, the audio version of these shows, which we've been compiling and prepping and getting ready to be published, just like the audio-only versions, should be up soon.
I love how we've said soon for like 15 videos.
Podcast app, Stitcher, just wherever you get your podcast.
Remember like the last Couchcast was like, what was it, like episode 8 or something?
And we were like, it was like 17, 15.
Was it?
Yeah. Something like that.
We're on like 29. This is 29.
That's awesome. It's been over a year.
No, it hasn't. We started this in December.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah. It's not a year until we hit 52.
Duh. You're right.
Now, but we're gonna hit more than 52 when we hit a year because we've done right. like a couple weeks. We did 2 a week.
Yeah,
that's a fucking awesome, man.
Yeah,
damn. You know, it's crazy when like you start doing stuff and it was like an idea that was in the back of your head and you told somebody, you put your finger in the face and like, I'm gonna do this, and nobody believed you.
Right.
Nobody believed me. Everybody wanted me to do it, but nobody believed me.
Well, it's funny. We were doing all this planning. We were making Mad Rational a name with logos and this and that, and you're like, you know what, that idea that I told you about, let's do that. Yeah, let's do that. And like the next week we sat in front of a camera
a GoPro
oh my god,
sat in front of a GoPro for 3 hours and recorded something.
Oh my god, that was it was super fun, but it was the worst.
Yeah. Compared to what we have now, it was the worst. But yeah. And then within a month we had speakers or microphones and
yeah, we knew we couldn't continue this like this, you know what I mean?
And then not long thereafter we had a camera. We slowly had sound foam.
Yeah. It evolved week after week after week. And now we're here. You know what's funny though? Everybody, we're still in the same place.
Yeah.
The location hasn't changed. The table is the same.
Right.
The tablecloths are the same ones. Just want to let you know.
In the same place.
I'm saying the tablecloths. The placemats. Everybody. The placemats. That's red.
The one placemat.
The one place. It's mine. Yeah. It's mine because I wouldn't let it go. He got rid of all the other ones, but I wouldn't let this one go because it's mine and it's red. And the table's black, and I just wanted the red and the black to go together because that's Matt Rational, red and black.
Right.
That's right.
Right.
That's it. Ironically, that's the color of the first two people that inhabited this continent.
Wait, what?
The first two groups of people that inhabited the continent was red and black. With dark skinned people. Red or toned people.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I think I see what you're saying.
Yeah. What is this?
My boys, you're the Ox.
My dudes. This fly is about to get every part of Thor's hammer in a second.
I think that.
These are the two dopest rappers that we've ever put on the kitchen.
Yeah, they're by far my favorite, I think.
They're tied with Blimes.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're tied with Blimes.
Right. Blimes and your girl Gab.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're dope.
Yeah.
I've been following Blimes. She's been doing a lot of stuff lately.
You know, it'd be dope if we could like get her on the show though.
That'd be so dope.
That'd be crazy. So shout out to anybody that's got connections and feelers.
To Blimes, Brixton, or Gifted Gab. Get them
either
both
one.
In. Yeah.
Get both of them and Method Man. Come on.
Right?
Come on. Come on. You know what I'm saying? And we do our first edition of I got to come up with a dope name. You know what I'm saying? I got to come up with a dope name for it. You know
you're knocking about. You're knocking about there a second ago. I know. Earlier today.
I know, right? Do you feel the hot fire? So what are we gonna call this like cipher section that we're gonna do?
Right. So we're gonna start having. I think the idea is we're gonna start having a local artist on to freestyle for you, freestyle for us. Just get him in. Kind of give him a place to show off. I think that'd be cool.
Yeah, I gotta come up with a name for it though.
The Mad Cypher. That's too obvious though.
Smoking a quarter of a key. My style wasn't born in the streets. Was molded by Nordic bonds and informed. I don't know. I'm gonna have to marinate on that a little bit. Rappers are silver back of the flip. It's still a tiller killer shit. Tell them that nomadic skills still exist. Been back and forth on a sprinter bus. Virginia trips, never ill equipped. My killer instincts, indigenous. My piff is pungent mixed. It's like swaying in the morning, got the five fingers of death. We're not trying to kill nobody. I'm reaching from an unscratchable itch on some unteachable, unnatural shit. You now rocking with the yachts. Time me up. just had a funny one into my head. Mom Spaghetti Freestyle. Trying to figure out where Mom Spaghetti comes from.
Yeah.
Eminem. Lose Yourself.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What the hell is this? Is this Outkast?
Oh yeah, man. In the place to be and not to be at the
same. Is this Stankonia?
No, this is the not the Love Below, but the other half.
That's off that, but what album is it?
The Love Below is one half, and then Speaker Box.
Oh.
This next part.
See, I wasn't always a fan of every Outkast song. That's how you feel? Feeling good, feeling
great. You didn't even know that was coming up, did you?
I did not. I wasn't ready.
He wasn't ready.
Feeling good, feeling great. Oh, that's. Uh-oh. That's
how we feel.
Oh. I was ready for grinding. Hey, why don't you put grinding.
The MC, oh, yeah, yeah.
The, with, you know, the one that had the thing and the stuff and the... I don't remember exactly, but it was tight. Why don't you put that on?
I'll bring in my turntables for that.
We should create another section with the GoPro where they could, like, we could have another mic set up.
Yeah.
We just need another mic stand. No, we got a mic stand. I'm tripping. Use that one. Oh, we just use the other one that's in there.
Which
MC is that?
I didn't say.
Because that's what it's for, because they're going to be spitting.
Yeah. Wait a minute, was it MC Chicken in the Hat? I remember him. He was a fat
dude. Wait, was he thin? Now I know I've seen his video up on the box with the dirty ass. So I always wanted, like, a different DJ name.
Yeah.
And
what was your DJ name?
It was the same, Twitch for Life. You know what I'm saying? It, same all the way around. But, like, if I would have been able to choose my own name instead of it, like, being given to me,
yeah,
I would have been DJ Cricket.
Why is that?
Because I make a lot of noise at night.
Good.
DJ Cricket. Kind of like I ripped that from DJ Chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Like straight, like maybe direct rap. MC, matter of fact, he got the authentic, easy riding his act. Always speaking the truth, never fronts
one bit. MC front a lot. Don't quit, but I think for some reason that it wasn't him.
Wait, was it MC? Why are you flowing like Slick Rick? Very risky rapping, don't know what happened to the
time. Verbal contortion is squeezing tongue portion. I love this kind of rap where it's like it's all a joke, it's all comedy, but at the same time it's done really well. Like, you're not tripping over the words. It's all very clean and skillful.
Yeah.
Skillful.
Word. Worked. What? Why? Yeah. Who's got a Star Wars remix? Ooh. Ooh.
Like, since listening to music, sitting down and listening to music with you, and like listening to the way you think about music, I've been far more aware of, like, the what do you call it, the, like, space,
the stereo image
that producers use.
There's so much space to put in sound, which is why, like, your regular standard hip hop is so frustrating to me, right? Because like you have 180 degrees of space, and actually more now, you really have like 270 degrees of space that you can put sounds in for people to hear in different places, right? And a lot of producers, they get it cluttered up. Like, you know, you get that section of sounds from like 60 hertz to 120 hertz. It's all cluttered, it's and all muddied up.
Smushed in there.
And then you have people with like low tone voices in there. And it's like, bro, you got a lot of space to put sounds.
Yeah.
Spread it out.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Stop having everything right smack in the center because it's boring. It drones on. It sounds like white noise when it's done with the mix.
Yeah.
You know, you don't have anything interesting. You know what I'm saying? I want to create a track that when something hits, you might look to the
you're looking like, behind you off to the side,
right?
Do you think part of the reason is because a lot of people are making those tracks for like a club setting where a stereo mix doesn't necessarily play well in like a room?
So all you have to do is bounce out a mono mix.
Yeah,
that's it.
But do you think that's what they're doing? Like they're playing?
I don't think anybody's thinking about it like that.
I know, like. The EDM producers are definitely doing that.
Well, so but it's EDM is only get played in one setting.
Well,
for the most part.
For the most part, yeah. But that's, I think, you get that line is blurred. It gets more and more blurred as we go down. Like all of these lils are.
So, but the thing about EDM though, EDM has less vocals than your standard hip hop in it.
Mm-hmm.
So you can put other sounds in that space.
Right.
And that pumping bass that's typically in your EDM music, it can sit right in the middle because that is the focus of the track.
Mm-hmm.
Right? That's what people are fist pumping to and all of that stuff in the club. You know what I mean? So that's fine, but it's a different genre of music and it should be mixed differently.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like a lot of the modern hip hop, a lot of at least the stuff that we hear on the radio now, is being made to be played for an EDM crowd. So like the little Yachty's and things of that nature. All of the Aesop tracks. Well, I won't say all of the Aesop tracks. Most of the Aesop Ferg tracks, the Aesop Aesop Rocky.
Aesop Rocky, yeah.
Those are made for like. Being played out live at shows,
and that's cool.
They have that.
But if you're playing out live at a show, every show has a stereo array.
Oh, definitely.
Right.
Definitely.
And having a live mix is okay. Like you should have multiple mixes of your track if you're gonna play it in different settings. Like if I mix out stuff for like if I know. Like, for instance, artists we work with all the time, Benji. If I know Benji's going to have a single and I know it's going to be played in a club, I have a club mix. Mm-hmm. I have a album mix. Mm-hmm. I have a radio mix. I have a clean mix. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
And then I have stems. You know what I mean? So then I also have a performance mix. If I know he's going to perform the track, it's a different mix for the performance mix to make sure his vocals sit right and they're not in the track. You see what I'm saying?
What do you mean by in the track?
So like his main vocals aren't in the track, but the ad libs are there, and it's mixed for a live setting, right? They're just different mixes.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. You might have seven different mixes for one track.
I think that's the right way to do it, but I don't think that's necessarily the way that it's done.
I do.
I think it definitely should be done.
Yeah.
But yeah, what we hear now is just it's frustrating.
Yeah. So thank y'all for listening this evening. Been great conversation, really fun. Tried a little different format today. No real structure, just, you know, natural conversation happening, you know, in between some, you know, pretty dope jams that we playing in the background. So, but look, we appreciate y'all. You know, if you like this video or this audio, because we're going to do this soon, like we said we was going to do,
right?
Hit that like button. You want to hear more, see more, hit that subscribe button and make sure you hit the bell next to it. So when we drop the video, you can watch it right at that moment. Anyway, we out, y'all. And for all my artists that's listening in, make sure if you want to be featured on an episode of The Kitchen, you go to submit@madrational.com with your bio and with your track. Drop it to us so you can get featured on the show. Cool? Right? And if you're local, or if you want to come down and kick it with us, we have no problem with that. Come kick it with us and be a guest on the show.
Right.
Come sit down with us. Talk to us.
We're gonna have you prepare a freestyle, though.
Yes. That's going to be the new tradition on The Kitchen, right? So you're going to have to drop a freestyle. So be ready. Be ready with your freestyles.
Right.
If you're a rapper, be ready. If you're a singer, be ready.
Be ready.
Anyway, y'all, once again, we out. Peace.